darkness and their rejection of Jesus Christ and teaching others to reject God. Oh, give thanks unto God of heaven, for his mercy endureth forever. Again, found in the Proclamation of President Washington. We had a president that knew what the Bible said and loved and honored God. Can we say that in the last decades? Absolutely not. We have had an utter rejection of God since Roosevelt. Hey, don't depend on God, depend on the government. We'll give you a check. And when you get that check, don't thank God, thank us. Thank the U.S. Postal Service for bringing it to you. We deliver for you. How about a wounded vet? Can he thank the government for his care? Absolutely not. How about a mother of 14 children, 200 fathers? Oh, she can thank the government. She can thank the taxpayers for being robbed by the government. Psalms 50, verse 14. Offer unto God thanksgiving. Hey, that's the name of the holiday. America. From. Now listen to me. You know you don't believe it. I got some sense here. America, since November 26, 1789, is the only country that has set aside one day for God. It is marked on your calendars, and you are going to be held accountable to that God for every Thanksgiving that you have celebrated outside of God. Since 1789, this country has set apart one day for the Almighty God. And the God's not a cowboy. Doesn't live in Dallas, so wherever they're going to play that stupid game. He can't be found on your plastic card. Oh, but when you get the bill in January, you'll be praying to God, oh, give me the money. Thanksgiving, the word Thanksgiving came out of the King James 1611 Bible, my friend. And when you see it marked on your calendar, it comes from the Bible. It is God's holiday. No atheists allowed. You want to worship Allah? Don't celebrate Thanksgiving of the Bible. Be a Bible-believing, born-again Christian to celebrate Thanksgiving because it's God's day. Catholics are not allowed because it's not Mary's day. That's Christmas. Mary's Christ Mass. That's your day. I don't celebrate the Mass. I celebrate a God that I give thanks to. I'll take Thanksgiving. You can have Mary's Christ Mass. Psalms 50, verse 14, offering to God thanksgiving. That's the name of the holiday. And pay thy vows unto the Most High. Oh, America, you're in trouble there. You're in there. Oh, do you take this man? Do you take this woman? Unto death do you part. Oh, I do. Adultery and fornication and divorce runs rampant in America. Maybe the reason why is that because you haven't thanked God. 1 Chronicles 29:13, a boring book, but 1 Chronicles. Now therefore our God, not Allah, not a cow God. I'm going to say cow God. The God of the Bible, who doesn't come back as a cow, who doesn't come back as Mary, the God of the Bible. Now therefore, our God, we thank thee and praise thy glory. before Thanksgiving Day. That'd be a glorious Thanksgiving. Except for some of you Christians, I didn't get no turkey. I didn't get to watch the Redskins. Oh, can't say Redskins, sorry. Oh, man. Can't watch the Cowboys lose. Oh. I didn't get to get that new phone series 400. Next year I'd get 401. It's no Thanksgiving. Ephesians 5:20. Giving thanks always for all things. Oh, that all things. Oh, God, my back aches. I have to thank you for it. I hear it, man. I work with men. Oh, that woman. I just give thanks. You could be single again and eating weenies all the day long. With dirty clothes. You don't even thank God for your job. You don't even thank God for the country that you live in. Go to another country and see what kind of respect and honor you'll get. First of all, if you go to another country, you're going to have to learn their language. You can't force English on them. They have no press one. Give thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Well, gee, these verses match what President General George Washington has declared before Congress, before the citizens of America, the United States, on October 3rd, 1789. I can go by what I have read to you by the National Archives of America. The fact is that General George Washington, your president, your commander-in-chief, tells you, the American citizens, to get in the Bible and worship the God of the Bible and give him thanks and praise. And
Old Testament, this is what the New Testament does to the Old.
And to confess the sins of this nation. That is what your president, and your president quoted from the New Testament, Book of Revelation. So by decree, the U.S. United States President George Washington, on October 3, 1789, you are, as American citizens, set apart Thursday, Thanksgiving, to give praise and honor and God. And if you don't, you are not obeying your government. You're not obeying God. And it will be a sin to you. As America and the sins that she's in, you should get rid of the turkey. And fast on Thanksgiving. Because America is in deep trouble with her sins. And judgment is coming. God has warned us over and over. One day that axe will fall. One day you'll take your dying breath, that last breath, and you will step out into eternity. And to step off to be with God is to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. But as a U.S. citizen of America, I thought that you would like to know what Thursday was meant, what Thursday's proclamation of your president is to be, and I hope you enjoy Thursday, praising God all day long and praying to Him. And remember, if you don't, I told you what the president says, I told you what the Bible says, and if you don't, it's a sin. One good thing about preaching, it doesn't give you any alibi. It doesn't give you any more excuses.